Hello, my friend. Today we're answering a Power BI question asked by Manolito Lanshear from Netherlands, a member of our Learn Power BI family. Manolito, thanks so much for your question. So Manolito shared this file, and Manolito works in the travel and tourism industry, has been working in that industry for a long time. And he shared with us, of course, anonymized random data of a hotel price sheet. Now, the challenge here is essentially taking what I would call this a human-friendly format and turning it into a more machine-friendly format, more of a tabular format, something like this, which Power BI can easily consume, and we can chart, we can graph, we can use in our model. So again, Manolito, thanks so much for your question. And this was discussed with Manolito. We worked on this problem together in our Q&A call, in our live Q&A call. And if you have any Power BI questions, you can ask them too. Just go to learnpowerbi.com/question. So let's look at the problem here. And the goal is to go from this format to this format. Now, if we were to break that down and step by step and just focus on, let's say, a single row. So we have this data, it's showing a week's worth of data for group one, group two, and so forth. For now, let's just focus on group one. So if you were to do group one, we do need to switch that or unpivot this data into rows, right? So we'll have that, but then after that, we also need to fill in the dates because this is a week's worth of data, so 5 July to 11th July. So we have those at the ends. But then we also need to kind of fill in the dates between that as well. And then we also need the group and the resort. And that's what, if we kind of, just reorder the columns there, we would get the final format that we're looking for: date, resort, group, amount. Now, if you realize here, there is also some complexity here, is that the headers are actually split in multiple rows. And after that, not only do we have to do this with one sheet, but we also have to do it with cycling through all the input sheets in the data. Now, that full complete solution, how to sort out or handle these headers, which are actually split in multiple rows, how to combine multiple sheets, that full solution is covered in our advanced program. And you can find out more about our advanced program by going to learnpowerbi.com/advanced. But for the purpose of this YouTube video, what we have done is we've taken that and simplified that a little bit. So what we've done is combined those headers into a single row, so you don't have to handle with the headers being in multiple rows. And then we've also simplified, and we're just going to focus on a single sheet. Now, if you really want to learn Power BI and not just watch this video and move on, then I would highly recommend that you also download this file by going to learnpowerbi.com/download and then follow along with the video or repeat the steps yourself after watching this video. So let's click on transform data. That's opens our Power Query Editor, which is the kitchen of Power BI. And we're going to point that to our Excel file. So new source, Excel workbook, hotel price sheet simplified. And we're going to select our input table from here and hit OK. All right, now this one, I'm going to designate this as the source because you're going to see it later. I need actually two things from this data. So I changed the name to source, and I actually right-clicked and unchecked the enable load. I don't quite want to load this data. So I'm going to right-click on this again and click reference. And this is the file that we're going to keep building. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to remove these header rows that we don't need. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm going to click remove rows, remove top rows. Click 5, hit OK. So now that those rows are removed, we can go ahead and promote this row as header. And for that, we're going to click right here, use first row as headers. I click that, and you can see our headers are in place. And now, of course, if you look at our problem, we essentially have data in columns, and we have to move that into rows. That's our first challenge. Now, there is the next challenge that we're going to tackle next, which is that this is actually not a single day's worth of data. This is a week span of data. So how do we deal with that? We'll take it step by step. But the first thing is, again, to unpivot that data. So I'm going to hold these date start and date end columns. I'm going to select both of them. And then I'm going to right click on this and say unpivot other columns, right? So the other columns, I want them to be transitioned to rows. And you can see this happening right here. Again, that data, which was spread out in rows, is now unpivoted into columns, right? So these were column headers, and now these values are captured in rows. So that's what unpivot does, which is one of my favorite operations in Power Query. All right, so now our real work really begins. So now we gotta figure out that, okay, this was for a week's worth of data, and then we have to decipher which one is that. So for that, one concept that I talk about is human learning comes before machine learning. So first you have to understand, like, how would a human do this, right? So of course, if I'm looking at this and I know that the week starts on, actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the date end column. That's actually confusing. We don't really need it. So let's remove that column and let's focus on the date start, right? So if you're looking at this now, date start, and this is a Monday. Now the week in this case, if you look at the data, it does start on a Monday. So if I'm looking at a Monday, it is this date, right? So if I'm looking at this cell is 20th December. What about the next cell over here? Well, the next cell is that date plus one. And the next cell after that is that date plus two, right? So you get the idea. Essentially, what we have to do is take the date start. And if it's Monday, add zero. If it's Tuesday, add one. If it's Wednesday, add two, and so forth. So let's, now again, so that's the human learning part. We understand that as humans, and now we just have to break it down step by step and teach that to the machine. Again, it's really simple, guys. Power Query or DAX or Power BI in general, you can take a complicated problem, just break it down into simple steps, and go from there. All right, so again, just as we said that humans can do it, we're gonna teach Power Query to do it. So first step, let's split out the, so right now it has both the group name and the Monday, Tuesday in the same column. We're gonna split that column so that it's separated. So I'm gonna right click on it and say split column by delimiter. And in this case, there's the pipe delimiter, which is already there. And I'm gonna choose the leftmost delimiter. Hit OK. So now we have the group name here and the weekday here. And I don't really usually like this automatic change type steps. So I'm going to actually delete this one. And I noticed there's another one up there too. I'm going to delete that one as well. So change type is gone. And here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually rename these. But sometimes I just, instead of adding another rename step, I just like editing the query right here. So in here, I can go, instead of calling it attribute, I can call it group or group name maybe. For now, let's say group is fine. And the other one is my weekday. All right, great. And actually, I'm going to go back. And here's the unpivot column. I actually wanted this one to be called amount, not value. So I'm going to change that as well while we're fixing column names. And I'm doing this because the output that Monolith had requested looked like that. So if you look at the output we want is the date, resort, group, amount, right? Okay, so come back here, go to the last step. Oh, I don't really want change type, so remove that. Okay, so we have the weekday amount, looks good. So let's keep going with the logic that we had. So again, we want to add zero for a Monday and one for a Tuesday. So we're just going to define a numeric column for that. So we'll call it weekday num, and it's a simple if and clause. So I'm going to say if weekday equals Monday, then zero, right? And else if weekday, I can just copy this one. If weekday is Tuesday, then one. and repeat that. So let me complete that and we'll be right back. All right, so we're almost done with this. So again, the same way human learning to machine learning, this is what we would have done as humans for Monday, add 0, Tuesday, add 1, and I've just taught that to Power Query, Power BI. But I'm gonna do one additional thing, which is just in case we get some data where it's not a match, I wanna raise an error. And the way to do that is you can just type in the word error like that, and then here you can specify the error message, and I'm just gonna say unknown weekday value, and I'll do that. And again, I don't expect to find this in the data, but this is what's called defensive programming. Just in case something doesn't work, maybe in future something breaks in my data, this is gonna catch it, it's still gonna be consistent. So again, you can see now we have this, which is really clean. And now, just as what we had done as humans, we're like, oh, cool, now add these dates to that date. So let's do that. Let's add another column. And this is gonna be kind of our final date. And this will be date.addDays. And we're gonna start with the date start. And we're gonna add the weekday num. Now, I'm not 100% sure if this is gonna complain about the data value not being date. Let's just give it a try, and then we'll fix it if we need it. I think it was able to automatically kind of recognize that it's a date, so that did work, so that means we're in business. Let's go back to the output that we're looking for. So the output we're looking for is date, resort, group, amount. Now really we do have the date, we don't have the resort name, we do have the group, and we do have the amount. So for the resort, we need to go back to the source, and that's why I had specified that as a source and referenced it. So now you know. And here, actually I made a mistake. I didn't really, so it had some automated steps that I didn't want them to be there. So I'm gonna remove them, I'm gonna remove the change type, I'm gonna remove the promoted headers. I do need the navigation. Now that does mean that I also need to change this file. So I'm gonna go all the way back and notice that now I actually need to remove 6 rows, not 5. So I'm gonna change the next step, remove top rows, and change that to remove 6 rows, and everything is gonna be as it was, at least for this query. So that one seems to be good now. It's back to that. Now let's go back to our source and we're gonna right click on it and reference this again. And this is where I'm gonna extract the resort name. Resort name. Now resort name is simply the first row and the column one. And the way to do that is simply you can go here, and to reference the first row, you can do curly brackets 0. So the rows are index-based, and it's a 0-based index. So 0 indicates the first row. And this would give you the first complete row. In fact, you can hit enter on this, and you can see what it does, and it's just giving you first row. And of course, the first row just has resort XYZ, and that's it, nothing else, and not very interesting. But actually, we don't want the whole row, we want the column one. And for that, we can specify kind of square brackets and the name of the column. And in this case, it's just called column one, and we hit okay. Now notice what happens here. Notice this query looks slightly different. That's because what it's saying, what it's trying to tell you is that this is a scalar value, which is just means a fancy word for it's like a single value. It's not a table. Most things in Power Query are gonna return a table. This is a table. But this one is a scalar value, which is fine by us. Now, hey, it's possible that in some scenarios you're dealing with a scalar value. Now you do have a button to convert it to a table if you want it, but we don't want that in our case. Now we'll go back to our query, and this is actually, I think we're ready to kind of rename it. So this is actually the output we're working on. So output of that 2021 table. And now let's add that column, custom column. And this one is super easy. So I'm just gonna check, I wanna match what he called it, resort. He's just calling it resort. And we're just gonna reference that other value. In fact, you can see autocomplete even shows me that value. So yeah, so it's just, I'm just saying, yeah, go pick up the value, stick that in this column. And that's now we have the resort name, right? Now, We're almost done. Let's go back. So it's date resort group amount. That's the format that they need. So I'm going to select date resort group amount, and I'm going to right click and say remove other columns. It also sorts or reorders the columns in the order in which I selected. So now I have the final format. Looks good. And again, you remember I removed the automatic change type steps. I don't like those. They can be really problematic. I'm not going to go into the detail of why right now, but I think we do cover that in our advanced lessons as well. But yeah, just trust me on that, right? You should be in control. Don't let Power BI stick in those automatic change type steps. So I want to be in control, and usually I typically focus on just numeric and date columns. You do want to set the type, but I usually always do it at the end when I'm done with all the transformations. Unless I need to add two numbers, and therefore I have to do that earlier. All right, so we're ready for that. So let's go to date, and I'm just going to change it to a date value. And this one, I'm going to change it to a decimal number. And that's it. That's our Power Query challenge. I want to thank Manolito again on working with me on this question on the live call. And as I said earlier, if you have any question, if you're stuck anywhere, just go to learnpowerbi.com/question, and we'll get that question answered for you. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, power on.